Hey, we got a call from the lady. She thought you were hurt.
Hey, good morning, guys. What's up? I'm on my way to this job that we're gonna do for someone, and the hill that we're gonna be on is extremely steep. So the lady's like 83. She's in a wheelchair. She can't really get around very well, and her husband passed away 2 years ago. And she's told me that when her husband was alive, he would mow this hill. What he would do is he would tie a rope to the lawnmower, have the lawnmower just turned on, right? And he would lower the mower down with this rope down the hill. And I don't know how steep this hill is. I'm gonna try and figure that out. But I think the slope is about, I imagine it's about a 45 degree angle, somewhere around there. I went back when I was looking at the property to begin with and talking to this lady, see if I could do it. I had to go back there and I couldn't walk around everywhere. The grass is really tall. There's blackberries that are taller than me, and there's a really tall arborvitae where she doesn't want it. So we're gonna cut that down. It just all needs to be cut down. And then afterwards I'm gonna come back and spray it so it doesn't grow back up so quickly, and so it'll last a lot longer for her. So I'll be doing that after the fact that you won't see. So this is a lot back here. I'm really excited about this property to help her out. So come along with me, sit back, chill, get some popcorn or something, because it's gonna be good. All right, guys. So I cleaned this little porch. What would you guys call this? Let me know in the comments. It's like a lookout, so they could sit here in a chair and look out over the city. The grass is about 2.5-3 feet tall, and I gotta do this whole hill with my weed eater and brush cutter. So as you can see, there's grass, right? There's scotch broom over there. And then what's hard to see is that over here we have blackberries, and the blackberries continue up all back there. So the whole, like probably half of this steep field is covered with blackberries. So let's get to it. guys, should we figure out the slope of this hill? All right, so there's level, right? We're at 50 degrees. 50 degrees, it's really steep. I don't think a vent track could even get up this. Anyways, interesting to find out. Also, I don't know where I'm gonna put you guys because the hill is so steep. I honestly don't know what to do with you guys. I don't have like a, what I need guys is a stake that I can put you guys on and then put you in the ground so you stay still. Actually, yeah, that wouldn't be a bad idea. Maybe I'll look into that.
From the lady. She thought you were hurt.
Oh.
She said she heard you yelling help or something. So instead of calling the PD, she called us.
Oh.
Just want to make sure you're all right.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay. We just thought maybe you got hurt or somewhere.
So, I just talked with my contact with the city. She came out here to check on me. Because she got a call from the homeowner saying that she thought I was calling for help because she heard some yelling. The neighbor over here was playing with his dogs and was yelling with the dogs. And so I think that was what she heard, but she thought I was the one hurt. And so the homeowner, the lady that we're helping, she can't see me, right? It's totally blocked. And so she called the city and had them come out and check on me. So that was nice of her. So yeah, it's nice to see that people care. All right, let's get back to it.
fall.
I was weed whacking and I think I picked up a branch or something and hit my leg. Right there. Now these are the thick ones too. So for it to go through there, for it to go through there, that's crazy. I've been hit with a lot of stuff, but it's never broken these before. That's crazy. Battle scar. It's not like I have allergies or anything. Okay. Are you ready for this? Are you ready? Let me hear you say. Just kidding. I can never be a DJ. We'll be right back.
Thank you. $200 tool.
Alright, let's get a thumbs up. Thumbs up for the broken tool.
Broken side here.
Thank you.
And just like that, we're out of string and we're out of time. So, see you tomorrow. Also, I gotta get that tool fixed. Oh, and stop tripping. Oh. Hello, guy. How you doing? Oh, bye.
Hey guys, we're back. This is day two. Our tool broke. This one broke. I didn't really fix it. I just took it apart, put it back together. I didn't see anything wrong, so I think it might be something in the gear head here. I was going through the Scotch broom, and if you know what Scotch broom is, it's just really, really tough and hardy. So I was going through a Scotch broom that's 2 inches thick, just really thick. Yeah, I think it was a bit much for the gears in here. So I might have to just buy a new one. Anyways, we're back at it. We're gonna try it on this, see if it works. There's a little bit of Scotch broom here. I don't think it's gonna do well on that, but we'll try to use it on the blackberries, and then we'll go from there. If it doesn't work, then we'll just have to buy a new one, and then you'll see me with a new one pretty soon. So here we go. Yeah.
guys, I know it's a lot of the same old stuff, but you gotta stick with me. You can't be falling over. Don't faint on this hill, you will die.
Guys, if I would have known there were steps, I probably would have done them first.
It's hard to see, but there's steps all the way down that level down there. All the way down.
The steps are just in the mud, but and dirt, but better than trying to mountain goat it, you know? Alright guys, we're gonna switch gears. I'm gonna take care of this tree here. Two trees. We're gonna have to go hands-on for this stuff because it's entangled with the whole tree. So we're gonna pull it all out. We're gonna set it to the side and then we'll mulch it up when we're all done. By the way, I clipped a little bit of this tree and it smells wonderful. The allergies that came from it, not so wonderful, but smell good. We'll be right back.
God.
Guys, the lady that lives here also requests that we take down this arborvitae. So she's got others, but they're all together and they make a nice hedge. This one's by itself and she says it's too tall for her. She doesn't want it. So we're gonna cut it down and haul away for her.
Alright guys, we gotta fit all of this in to it.
this.
Pro tip for anybody that uses a tarp to tie down stuff when they have to go to the dump and whatnot. This is a mesh tarp. What's great about these is that I can put this on there, and yes, it has holes. It's got little holes so I can tie it down. But the wind will go through this. So the wind goes through this. It doesn't destroy this tarp at all. Unlike, you know, regular tarps, they kind of block the rain and the wind. But if you're driving at 60 miles an hour, I mean 55, the speed limit, right? So if you're driving at 55, then the wind is going to want to take your tarp and whatever's in it and just throw it out the back of your truck. But if you have one of these, it doesn't do that. Alright guys, well that was a doozy, wasn't it? That was a big one. That was probably, it's probably about a easy quarter of an acre back there that we did on the hillside. Like I said in the beginning, the degree of that hill is 50 degrees. You take 90 degrees, right? Cut that in half, that's 45. Just go up a little bit from there, it's 50. So it's pretty steep, as you know, you might have seen. So in the comments, let me know how many times I slipped, because I kind of lost count. So yeah, count them up, let me know in the comments how many times I slipped, and I will see you guys on the next one.